After defining intents and entities, as a chatbot creator, you would typically focus on designing the dialog. Creating a dialog defines how your bot will respond to what the user is asking. Dialogues in WhatsApp conversation are defined visually through a user interface that is structured around the concept of nodes. Each node has a name, a condition, and one or more responses. There are a few more bells and whistles available, but at its core, we're talking about name, condition, and responses. The dialog starts executing from the first node at the top. If the condition is met, it will reply to the user with the response specified in that node and stop the execution until the user has entered some new input. If the condition is not met, it will skip the response and proceed to consider the next node below. If this second node's condition is met by the user's input, the node's response will be sent to the user. If the condition is not met, we continue to the next node, and so on. Essentially, the execution from top to bottom continues while the node conditions fail to meet what the user inputs as entered. For the condition, you can use intents, entities, a specific entity value, and a few reserved conditions like welcome, anything else, true and false. You can also combine intents and entities with AND and OR logical combinations. Typically, you'd want to greet the user as they arrive. So the first node might use the special word welcome as the condition, ensuring that that particular node is executed the first time that the user starts interacting with the chatbot. The response we configure in that particular node will be our initial prompt that greets the user, inviting them to chat with our chatbot. If the user input doesn't match any of the node's conditions, by default, no response will be provided to the user. And this isn't great from a user experience standpoint, because nobody likes to be ignored. So it's a good idea to have also a node at the very bottom of the dialog that is always executed if the user input failed to satisfy the conditions of any of the other nodes above. The failover condition for this node is called anything_else. When will this node be executed? In practice, when our bot has failed to understand the user. So in this node, we should have an appropriate response that invites the user to rephrase or maybe suggest some queries that we know our bot can handle. If we only included a single response in this node, the bot could get annoying rather quickly. Imagine seeing "I don't understand" over and over again. Hopefully our user won't trigger the anything else node too often, but it would be good to have multiple responses with some variation to them, even if they all express the same concept. It's a small detail that can affect the user experience and how intelligent our chatbot appears to be. These responses are executed sequentially by default. So the first time the user asks for something that our chatbot doesn't understand, our anything else node will be hit, and it will show the first response to the user. When this happens again, because the user enters something else that we don't understand, the second response will be shown instead, and so on. It's also possible to set the order as random by clicking the Set to Random link under the Responses block. These two nodes handle such common scenarios that they appear by default when you create a new dialog. That's quite handy, since all you have to do is then customize them with what you want in the prompt and what kind of "I don't understand" responses you want to include and send to the user. It's also possible to create children nodes. These are considered for execution only when the parent's node's condition is met first. Normally, the flow of execution for a particular user input is stopped once the condition is met by one node. We send back a response, wait for more input, and then restart the cycle, evaluating this new input against the conditions in our nodes top to bottom. However, if the matching node has children nodes, the execution continues with its children, not with the main nodes. If a parent node has multiple children, they are considered top to bottom. It turns out this is quite useful in practice. In fact, it's common to have a parent node ask for further clarification to the user in its response and then handle the specific information provided by the user in its children nodes. For example, the parent node might be triggered by the user asking, "I'd like flower suggestions for a special occasion." It doesn't provide information about which specific occasion. So the response from the node might be, "Which occasion?" When the user replies with, say, "birthday," the child node that matches the birthday condition will be executed, and its response displayed to the user. For this to work, will need multiple children nodes, each having as its condition an occasion value like anniversary, funeral, etc., each having an appropriate response. Alternatively, we can take advantage of the fact that responses themselves can have conditions attached. A node can have multiple responses that are only processed if their own condition is met. So instead of having multiple children nodes, one for each occasion, we could have a single node that provides different responses depending on which occasion value is provided in response to our request for clarification. Children nodes can have children nodes of their own, giving us the ability to create a quite complex dialog flow. Furthermore, we have the ability to jump from one node to another, something that can complicate our dialog flow, but which will be necessary at times in order to accomplish what the chatbot needs to do. Don't worry if this is a bit overwhelming. We covered a lot of ground to give you a theoretical foundation. When we create our chatbot in the next module, you'll become much more familiar with how we use parent, children nodes, conditions, and responses in order to define a convincing conversation flow for our chatbot.